everyone. It is 4:51 p.m. Central Time on Friday, July 8th, 2016. Hope everybody's doing good. And I've got you looking at Earthquake 3D. We're looking at the last 3 days of earthquakes recorded on the West Coast, 3.0 and greater in the United States and internationally. I've got it turned up here a little bit. And, oh, actually, it's not turned up to 3.0. There, now it's at 3. You can see the whole West Coast has moved from the coast of Oregon to the Gulf of California on a 4.3, 4.5, and 4.7 basis from north to south, or from northwest to southeast, the youngest earthquake being the 4.7, and the oldest earthquake being the 4.3, actually 3.1. So the 3.1 struck first, then the 4.3, then the 3.8, then the 4.3 and 4.5, then the swarm in the Midwest, then the 4.7 down here to the south. So that's pretty interesting to see that that all occurred in the past 2 to 3 days. We were expecting to see the pressure transfer to the east-southeast from the movement off the West Coast, and now that's occurred. Has occurred as far east as the Midwest with a new swarm. The latest earthquake in the Midwest is the 3.0, and that is right here on the map. And that's at the fracking operations in Oklahoma. So we have to watch to the east. Of course, the pressure has transferred over the past couple days down the coast. We only have a silent spot in between Southern California and the 4.7. And another silent zone between the 4.7 and the swarm all the way down in Ecuador. That puts our middle point at Costa Rica, right in this region here. So be on watch. We're watching for additional movement to occur, and it should fall somewhere between the 4.7 and the 5.3 range. If it goes any larger, I'll be kind of surprised. It should be similar in size, so it shouldn't be too large of an earthquake yet. Over in the West Pacific, we have some silent zones that have started to show movement, as well as a rare earthquake in southwest Australia, 5.2, striking due east of Perth by several hundred miles. Following that, a 5.4 struck along the, well, what fracture zone is this? The Kurrenstorf Ridge. I'd never heard of it before today, so it doesn't normally get struck. But on the Kurrenstorf Ridge, southwest of New Zealand. So 5.4 there, 5.2 here. Those are rare earthquakes to see up to the north. Let's look in Asia. And we have no new activity striking to the north over the past 24 hours. You can see the cluster down to the south. Whoops, that's just over 24 hours. Hold on. That is 24 hours. You can see the cluster to the south, but nothing to the north. Then we get up to the Kuril Islands, Alaska region, which is the far north, but nothing across Japan, Taiwan, Philippines, nothing in Sumatra. So a fairly large silent zone next to where the deep earthquakes occurred. Now we look at the last 48 hours of activity. Oh. 4.2 earthquake just struck in Oklahoma at the Kansas border. Just as expected, I told you guys to watch for 4.0 activity to strike here in the Midwest. As I mentioned many times before, the 4.3 that knocked the chimneys down, knocked facades off houses. As you can see, it just struck, as I'm talking, a 4.2 magnitude earthquake, fairly large for the Midwest. And this follows the activity, the 4.0 activity in the West Coast. And I just told you guys, we need to watch to the east, and I told you this morning, watch in Oklahoma for larger activity to strike in the 4 range. And now it has struck. I think at this point, we should probably pull up the earthquake statistics and go pull the earthquake, show everybody what's there. Of course, my longtime viewers already know what's at this location. But since it was in the forecast, since we had several days warning for this 4.2 to strike, the reason this 4.2 struck is because previously, let me show you the 4.0 and greater activity over the past few days. Over the past 3 days, we saw a 4.3 off the West Coast, a 4.3 due west at the California-Nevada border, and that has since been, or 4.3 and 4.5, that has since been followed by a 4.2 just now over the past few minutes in central Oklahoma. And this is craton movement. This is what happens. The earthquakes progress to the east. I think this vindicates me 100% in the debate between myself and Professor Vidali, who said there is no earthquake progression across the craton. And here it is again. We were watching for it, and it occurred. So I have the coordinates from the USGS, and we will open up a fresh copy of Google Earth to show you guys what's going on, just in case you're just now tuning in. A 4.2 earthquake just struck in Oklahoma, just as expected, the expected magnitude and the expected location at the expected time. So we've got our copy of Google Earth, and I've got my coordinates for the earthquake from the USGS. Let's zoom in on the area. Now, I've researched this area at length in the past, so you'll see several place marks indicating past research areas where I've marked earthquakes. But we need to mark this one since it's the largest earthquake to strike in a while. What is today? July 8th, 2016. Okay. And we'll back this out and look what we have just a few hundred feet away. We have our nearest frack well, which I will also mark for future reference. And technically it's FRAC, so we frack well. And we have another one to the south. I should probably mark that one too, since it's also close. Okay, so that's what you do. If you use Google Earth, you definitely mark the nearby locations. And this is within, let's get a line measurement tool of how close the nearest well is. It is 0.3 miles, or 0.5 kilometer, so 500 feet, or I'm sorry, 1,637 feet. So a little over a half kilometer, but there it is. So what can I say? Frack well at the location, 4.2 striking central Oklahoma following 4.2s off the coast. No doubt people felt this in the region. This is what the Earthquake 3D live stream is for right now. Let's get back over and check it on the full screen so my mouse matches up. Again, we see that the movement occurred off the west coast a few days ago, the 4.3, followed by a 4.5 and 4.3 at the California-Nevada border yesterday, additionally a 3.8 down at Salton Sea Volcanic Buttes, and then over to the east, as we'd expect, followed by a 4.5 and 4.3 at the California-Nevada border yesterday, additionally a 3.8 down at Salton Sea Volcanic Buttes, and then over to the east, as we'd expect. Pressure transferred and released at the weak spot, which is the fracking operations. The humans have punctured the crust over multiple miles. Let me show you again the size of this pumping operation. You'll begin to understand why earthquakes are striking there. Now, I just marked the nearest two wells, but we have a bunch of these little whitish looking pads out here. Each pad is a different pumping operation. You can even make out the shadow of the oil well at the top of there, the pump. Then you'll be able to see that the operation extends down here to the river, each one of these. Okay, every single pad that you see is a different pumping operation that's been drilled out. And we get up to the north, see all these little white specks. Every one of those is a different pumping operation. Zoom in and show you to prove that. Because some people say, oh, those are just farm fields. I said, no. You're missing what we're talking about. You're seeing the greater squares, and you're missing the little white specks inside of each square. And it goes up here to the north, many more, each one along the road. And they may even have a few at street level, so we can actually get a view on a couple of these so you can see what it looks like at ground level. You know what? They sure do. They've got a ground level right here. Now, let's hope it's recent, because if the ground level isn't recent, it's not going to show the frack wells. Ah, look at that. They were still drilling it. They had just installed it. Look how fresh all that equipment and gear is. Nice Humvee out there. Look at that. They're making some money. And over here on this side, fresh new well as well. Just to give you an example of what these look like from a ground level. So there you go. Again, if you're just now tuning in, let me bring you back over to Earthquake 3D and show you a 4.2 earthquake just struck in Oklahoma. And we were expecting 4.0 activity to strike the Midwest based upon the earthquake forecasts issued over the past few days. The people in Oklahoma had a three-day warning for this. It started with the activity off the coast, has progressed eastward as expected, east-southeast, from the locations which were already struck yesterday and the day before. We issued multiple warnings, told people to get the word out multiple times, and if any damage occurred off this, which I'm guessing there'll be light damage, as a 4.3, which struck at the start of this year, caused chimneys to fall down and facades to fall off houses. Now we've located the well nearby within just a few thousand feet, 1,500 feet away is the nearest well, and we were expecting this activity based upon the movement to the west. We now really have to watch to the east, up the eastern edge of the craton, the nearby fracking operations, in addition to this 4.2. This causes what I call a super fracture. You got to understand the physics behind what's going on here. We have pressure coming from the west coast, coming from up underneath the plate to the west, and pushing to the east, southeast. This displaces the magma chambers on the west coast, and it displaces the pumping operations in the Midwest. As the pressure's coming up from below, it seeks out a weak spot to release at. And they've drilled in thousands of puncture points into the crust by multiple kilometers, which are acting like pressure release valves. And as the pressure hits those pumping operations, it causes an earthquake like what we see here. That earthquake shakes up the nearby wells and causes cracks in their casements. Now those wells have gas and water under pressure, thousands of others I just showed you on the screen. And when they surround this, let's get out of the street view here and get it back out. Just hang on 1 second, guys. Okay, let's zoom back in on the 4.2 epicenter just to show you. The nearby wells, and this could go up to a few miles away, will experience cracks in their casements. Each well containing gas and water under pressure below each pump, and that then causes other earthquakes when the gas and water under pressure break out into areas where they're not supposed to in the lighter levels of shale to the more towards the surface. We start to see additional larger earthquakes, which then causes a domino effect of other cracked casements, which causes other earthquakes, and we see multiple dozen, hundreds of earthquakes develop off of a super fracture. And I had to come up with that term, super fracture, to describe what we're seeing, because they denied that any of this was happening. And this is what caused the Oklahoma swarms to develop, was a super fracture in the upper 4 to lower 5.0 range that struck in 2011, or 2010. No, it was 2011. And then that caused the thousands of earthquakes that we see spread out like a fracture in a windshield. So it spreads out, it builds upon itself, and it causes other earthquakes like a domino effect. They just keep falling once you see a super fracture. And it occurred here. It occurred right along the edge of the craton, which I've shown multiple times, so many times that it's getting to be this kind of, you know, repetitious event where I am just repeating myself in almost every update. But I almost have to, because we see a repeat in plate performance. In other words, the way the plate moves, almost every single week. And when I talk about the edge of the craton, you can see the bend in the craton over to the east. You see how it bends down here into the south and curls back up, going back down the Mississippi Valley, coming across Arkansas here. Here's Arkansas, and then it goes west. Let me turn off these photos. It goes west, and then it kind of becomes hard to see throughout Oklahoma here, but here's Arkansas going over into Oklahoma. Then the plate makes a bend down to the south where it becomes more visible down in Texas. And this is a 1,000-foot rise over 50 miles. You go from 500 feet to 1,500 feet, across maybe 50 to 100 miles at the most. So it's a 1,000-foot rise, but you can see the edge of it, the edge of the plate, curls down here to the south. Then it bends back up to the north and goes up the front range, meeting back up at Yellowstone, going up to the north where it becomes more pronounced again. And you can see the defined inner edge of the North American plate, the craton. And it goes back down here. Let me turn the borders back on, you'll understand where the fracking operations are. The fracking operations existing in South Wyoming, Western Colorado, Northeastern Colorado, Southern Colorado, Northern New Mexico, extending south all the way to Western Texas near Fort Stockton, going all the way across Texas. We know Texas big for oil, but the fracking operations now taking over. Going up through Dallas, here we have Dallas, and it goes right up into Oklahoma and Kansas, where it dead ends into Oklahoma and Kansas, makes a hard right across Arkansas, where we have a ton more fracking operations. They've been getting hit lately. Then we get back down here to where the plate bends, down here to the south, and we get into Alabama near Birmingham and up near Tuscaloosa, fully surrounded by thousands of frack wells, just like what we were looking at in Oklahoma. Take a look at it. See each one of these? Each one is a fracking operation and a pumping operation. You can make out the oil wells. Here's the shadow. And you say, wow, Alabama, and Alabama being hit by earthquakes. Well, look at the fracking operation. It's huge. All right? And then it goes right along the edge of the craton up through where Pigeon Mountain Volcano is. Most people don't know there's a volcano there. Let me show you. Flat Rock Point, Pigeon Mountain Volcano, here on the eastern edge of the craton. And it kind of still looks like an ancient volcano. And down here, they're mining it. And when you come in at street level view, you'll see the name of this mining company is Vulcan Mining Company. And we have a street level. Let's take it right down to the very tip, and I'll show you, just to prove it. Because I know a lot of people question whether or not we're telling the truth on YouTube. I don't blame you, because YouTube's loaded with BS. But look, Vulcan, V-U-L-C-A-N, Mining Company. And there they are extracting ancient volcanic materials from the ancient volcanic chain that exists here. It's not just one volcano. Let me show you. This is the volcano here, but there's more to the south. And you can actually see they're still covered by trees, but you can make out the ridges of the old buttes and the old caldera that makes up this, well, clearly large volcano. At an angle, you can really see it. But there it is. That's northern Georgia. That little edge of the craton, the break in the plate, and look how it goes up to the northeast. That's the next spot to get struck. It will get struck this week. That's the eastern edge of the craton. The western edge of the craton goes right here through Oklahoma, bends down through Texas, kind of dead ends into South Kansas. So in case you're just tuning in now, let's just quickly get back over to the live stream and see how many people are in here. Looks like about only 170. I guarantee you more than 170 people felt this 4.2 earthquake in Oklahoma. And I think over 172 people would be concerned about earthquake forecasting in general, don't you guys? Now, I know that number is much bigger, and I know that just reflects what's on my channel, but please get the word out and tell them they can rewind this video. That once this video is done, once I'm done doing this update, you can share the video right now and just tell them to rewind and they will hear the update. Everybody needs to know, a mid-4 has struck in the middle of the plate. It struck in the exact area that was warned. We've been warning for the last 2 to 3 days for this to strike after the 4.3 off the coast. And as I said yesterday, it's not going to lose much momentum when it presses to the east now that we saw a 4.3 strike at the California-Nevada border. So just 0.1 less struck over to the east. And even if they revise that down to a 3.5, I'm telling you now, this is the earthquake we were expecting. And we'll see the USGS do this revision game once they catch wind on, you know, that it was forecast. But that's fine. We're leaving it at 4.2, even if they don't. So they can go ahead and revise it all they want. I'm telling everybody 4.2, no matter what they change it to, because that's what it is. It's moderately large movement, striking at the middle of the plate in the exact area warned, following fours to the west. And we always see it press to the east, so that means we now need to watch further to the east along the eastern seaboard, going up into Quebec, southeast Canada. Again, up here to the northeast, right along the edge of the craton, going down the east coast. We already talked about this yesterday. So the fact that it's happening now today is proof that, first, earthquakes can be forecast. Secondly, it's proof that earthquakes are transferring from the West Coast to the East Coast, defying all of modern-day geology that says that the Mid-Atlantic Ridge is spreading over to the east here and pushing us this way, to the west, and that there's some kind of subduction going on over here. Oh, really? Well, could you please show me that? Because I'm from Missouri. Show me. I don't want to see some seismic soundings based upon measurements off the asthenosphere that are misread. I'd like to see that subduction zone. As a matter of fact, we don't see it. There is no portion where where the Pacific is passing underneath the United States or North America. The thing that's underneath North America is magma. The same thing that's underneath the Pacific plate, magma. They don't go underneath each other. They move laterally, side by side. One just so happens to physically be located next to the other, below the other one. I showed that over and over again around the whole plate. Not just the United States, but Central America, South America, over in Asia as well. That the Pacific plate itself just lies about 20,000 feet below all the other plates. And there's a giant ridge that comes up on all sides. It doesn't pass underneath the plates. Underneath the plates is the asthenosphere, the melted magma, and it comes up in the volcanoes. There can't be another plate underneath our plate. It would block all the volcanoes. It would knock all the magma chambers out, take them away. So, what does it all mean? It means earthquakes are progressing from west to east in a matter of a couple days' time. And the momentum that's lost is not much if an earthquake strikes interior to the coast. So if it strikes out to sea, we see a little bit of loss of momentum pressing to the east. But once it strikes on the plate or the interior of the plate, like in California, Nevada, it pushes to the east quickly and it doesn't lose much steam. So it only lost 0.1 off that. And, you know, they may revise it. I'm going to keep it at 4.2 even if they don't, because it's 0.1 less than the 4.3s that we see over here to the west. And we were expecting that. We talked about it. It was forecast. People in Oklahoma had at least 2 days warning. So that's what it is. This is the live stream, so it is what it is. I hope you guys enjoy this and support my research. If you can, could you please share it? There's Twitter, Facebook, however you guys share your stuff. Please share it. Get it out that the people had a 2 to 3 day warning for this to occur. So if any damage occurred in people's houses, it's just because they didn't get the warning from you guys. The authorities aren't going to get it out ever. They're denying that earthquakes can be forecast. So we can't rely on them at all until they shape up their act, right? I mean, they have to shape up or ship out at this point. Some professionals have to get on board with earthquake forecasting at this point. I almost demand it. Scientifically speaking, you need to drop who I am, Dutch Sinse, Michael Janich, put aside all the BS, and just look into earthquake forecasting. I'm begging you. If you're a professional and you get this, I'm begging you. You can do it in secret. I know it's professional credibility ruined when you go into the topic. Do it in secret. Follow what I'm telling you, just do it in secret. And all of a sudden, after a few years' time, you can roll out a paper on it or something, and you'll be the famous one. You don't even have to give me credit at this point. They'll never give it to me. But I just want to show you guys, the people who are here now, the 200 people out of 7.5 or 7 billion people on the planet, there are 200 people here who are going to get the word. And I think it's because they don't want people to know. Otherwise, there would be 1,000 people in. There's 1,000 people in Oklahoma that felt that would go online and immediately search the information. There's at least 1,000 viewers of mine that are Oklahomans that would feel that, because I know for certain several tens of thousands of people in Oklahoma and Kansas, Texas, are subscribers. So they felt it, no doubt about it. People in central Oklahoma felt it. People in northern Oklahoma felt it. Maybe even felt in Oklahoma City, probably, at least northern Oklahoma City, and certainly in South Kansas. So if all those people felt it, and there's at least 1 million people around there, I would expect to reach more than 200 people on a big earthquake like this. The fact that there's not, and other people around the planet wouldn't be tuning in for the earthquake forecasting, that to me is suspect as well, because what, do people, only a couple hundred people in California want to know when an earthquake's going to strike? Or do only a couple hundred people on the East Coast in New York only want to know when
you know, don't want to know when an earthquake's going to strike. They want to guess. Really? They don't want to know. Well, I asked that question rhetorically because it seems like they don't want to know. Because otherwise, they'd be getting the word that people would be sharing it and say, hey, did you see that there's this guy on YouTube forecasting earthquakes correctly? And nailing it down to a date and a time and a magnitude, and it's hitting every time. He just hit California and the Midwest in this past week alone. And last week he hit the Southern California. I mean, why aren't people tooting that horn? I can't do it. It sounds like bragging. But if you guys do it, all of a sudden it gets out. So I have to ask you to share it. That's all I can do. I can't force you to share it. I can't coerce you into sharing it. I just have to explain to you reasonably why it would be important for you to share this information. Okay? You can rewind it. You can listen again. I'll probably be stopping the stream in about 20 minutes to save it to my channel so people can have this as a documented video on my channel forever. To do that, I have to shut down the live stream. So I kind of have a choice right now. I can either let it go for a little while and let people share it and get the word out, then stop it, or stop it now and no one will ever see it except for when it posts to my channel. I would propose that you guys should share it. We'll let it go for a while. I'll let it go for another hour or two. Then I'll hit stop and it'll save that 2 to 3 hour length, starting with this 4.2 that just struck in Oklahoma. One last time, in case you're just now tuning in, a 4.2 earthquake struck in Oklahoma in the exact area warned, with the exact magnitude warned in the time we were expecting. The location itself is a fracking operation. I just looked it up for everybody, but I think I'll look it up one more time just to show you guys at home, in case you don't know what's there. We'll bring up the place marks I have for all my past research, and then we will zoom in on the location where the earthquake struck. Okay, and here is our earthquake epicenter, a 4.2 currently, and the nearest well is about near 1,500 feet away. There's one there. We also have what appears to be an older well here to the north. That may actually not be. No, that's not a well. And you can tell the difference. This is scary too, because this is a windmill that's pumping off water for cattle, pulling water out of the aquifer. Well, if you think about it, look at the nearby water wells, wastewater wells. Well, what does that mean? That means they could be possibly giving their cattle polluted water. So many nearby frack wells, so it's unbelievable. But when you see it, there it is, right on the screen in front of you, undeniable for all to see. The fracking operation struck yet again at a time of seismic unrest, a time when we would normally expect earthquakes to strike this spot. It's been struck. And why? Because pressure comes from the West Coast and travels to the East Coast. And if you live on the East Coast, you need to pay attention to what happens on the West Coast and in the Midwest, because it heads your way. And with the loss of momentum right now being what it is, I would say we might see a moderate earthquake strike in the Northeast. Could strike as far south as that fracking operation I just showed you in Alabama, unfortunately. So that's a huge area that needs to be on watch right now, extending from central Alabama, north Georgia, western Carolinas, western Virginia, northern New York, northern Pennsylvania, whole state of New York to the west, going north into Quebec, picking back up to the northeast in Nova Scotia, Maine, and New Brunswick, Canada, right at the split that exists up here in the Craton to the northeast. So this whole line right here, the mountain ranges, needs to be on watch for moderate earthquake activity less than the 4.2. This is going to press to the east and cause additional earthquakes again from down here at the fracking operations, up along the mountain ranges where we pick back up in oil and fracking operations and coal across Pennsylvania and New York. New York had the huge fracking debate. They decided not to do any new wells, so they only have the ones that they already have. And then going back up into Quebec along the natural edge of the Craton that shows the pressure released to the northeast. So much love, guys. I mean, what can I say? Earthquake Forecasting 101. This is why I'm writing the book on the subject. It should hopefully be out by the end of the fall. I'll have it all done. It'll be the full magnum opus on how to forecast seismic events, what I've discovered so far, deep earthquakes, shallow earthquakes, asthenosphere, earthquake progression, progression across the plates, progression across the seas, how earthquakes are related to each other, superfractures and fracking earthquakes. It's all going to be in there. And it's going to have a key of terminology that some of the terms I've had to create myself. I mean, how often do you have to do that? Create a new word. We had to create new words to describe some of the things that are happening, like in Oklahoma with the superfracture. That's not a word. I had to make that up, superfracture. And a superfracture describing a large fracture that occurs across a large area, and it happens in succession of one another, like dominoes falling on a set up across a course. What can I say, folks? Get the word out. Please share me. And if you can, give me a like up and give me a subscribe. It's worth it, because I'll tell you what, there's only one person on the planet right now that's doing accurate earthquake forecasting down to a date, time, location, and magnitude. And that person just so happens to be catching so much crap online you wouldn't believe it. That guy's me. I'm talking about me in the third person. I can't really say it because nobody else will toot my horn. But there it is. Love you guys. Thank you for sharing everything. Thank you for getting the information out. There's a lot of people that are concerned about the information. I know it. And they will get this if you guys tell them, please just rewind this video. You can hear the whole update and hear why the 4.2 struck in Oklahoma. Guaranteed it caused some damage. People's houses. Guaranteed. Some houses, you might never hear about it, but there are broken objects, things that are cracked that people might not notice for a little while. Foundation crack, a drywall crack, maybe even infrastructure leakage. Maybe even pipeline leakage. Certainly other earthquakes will develop off this 4.2, because the superfractures always cause other earthquakes, shakeups at other wells, and leaks. We were expecting it. Now you see it. I'll be back. Much love, guys. And ladies.